Welcome to Trent Kids Online. My name's Josh.
And I'm Dan.
And it's so good to have you with us today. How are you, Dan?
I'm fine. I'm a little confused.
By the get well, you know, I thought it's a special video today, Dan. You know, it's the end of our series. The last one before Easter. We've got some really exciting stuff coming up today. So I thought I might as well
dress as a Blues Brother.
No, just, you know, dress for the occasion. You know, okay. Get a bit fancy. Yeah. Bit stylish, bit cool, you know.
Yeah, and you're going to do that sometime soon, are you?
Oh!
No, Josh. No, my bigger question isn't really... I mean, you do look very smart suave. And I'm
Thank
sure everybody at home is dazzled by your beauty.
Thank
but,
you.
But how are you going to do the dance-off in that gear?
I'm going to level with you. I hadn't really thought of that, how I'd do the dance-off. Mm. But I've still got my trainers on, so, you know, I think that might be all right.
And, maybe more importantly... Are you okay getting gunged in that?
Oh yeah, that's a good point. I might get gunged today.
There's no might, Josh. You always get gunged. We all know.
It's true that my track record isn't great. I tell you what, I'll get changed during the dance-off. Because, I think you're right. This is probably...
It's maybe a little overkill.
It probably won't work today.
As good as it looks.
But anyway, as we said, we've got a really great video for you lined up today. We've got some fun stuff coming up. We've got... Our own resident Ash Wednesday is going to be making an appearance.
Ash Wednesday, it's just proof that if you hang on a joke for long enough, it will eventually come round again.
Oh, there's so many jokes in these videos that I have the same hopes for. But so we got that. Mm-hmm. We've got some dancing, we've got some games, but most excitingly, we have got gunging. You alluded to it already. One of us is going to get gunged by the end of today's video. It's either Dan or me. One of us is going to get gunged. So tune in for that. It's going to be great. It's going to be a great video, isn't it?
It's going to be a super video. And because it's the end of the series, I thought I would spend a little bit of my week preparing. And I've actually put together a bit of a highlights reel.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Have you got that to show us?
Yeah, it's literally ready to go. Yeah.
Okay. Should we see Dan's highlight video?
There's something wrong there.
Quite a voice.
There are things there that you are not going to be able to unsee. Ah.
Yeah. I'm guessing that wasn't the highlight video you meant to show us.
No.
No.
No. I'm shocked. I'm shocked, and I'm struggling. That is not what was meant to happen.
Oh, right. Okay.
I don't understand where that. How.
Well. Anyway. While Dan deals with that, and we try and find the actual video, why don't we go to the big dance-off, and then hopefully by the time we come back. We'll have found the actual highlight video. Is that all right?
Yes.
So let's go to the big dance-off.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to move it, move it.
This is something new, the Casper Slide Part 2, featuring the Platinum Band. And this time, we're gonna get... Turn it out, funky, to the left, take it back now y'all, five hops this time, hop it out now, right foot, let's stop, left foot, let's stop, right foot again, left foot again, right foot, let's stop, left foot, let's stop, freeze, everybody clap your hands,
bring me down, can't numb, bring me down, cause love is too high.
Shuffling.
amazing work, guys. You guys are so good at the dance off every single week. The bar is being raised higher and higher. Now, Dan, any news on the highlights video?
Yeah, so apparently I'm just hearing that somebody, and I'm not going to mention any names as to who, has possibly recorded over the highlights video with the thing that you just saw.
Right.
So that what that means is that there is no highlights reel.
No highlight video at all?
No.
No. Okay. Well, that's a shame. But I guess you guys at home, you can just make your own ones. We'd love to see those. There have been lots of great moments, haven't there?
Lots of great moments. Many highlights.
And many more still to come in this video. So I think we should move on and
yes.
do the announcements. Everyone's favourite bit of all church videos, the announcements. So I had written the announcements down, Dan, but actually it's gone missing from my clipboard and I can't seem to find them. Do you know where my announcement sheet has gone?
Yeah. Well, I do, actually, Josh. These may be quite helpful for you.
Oh, dear. You've made some changes, I've seen, to my announcement note.
Changes, I think, improvements is a better way to put it, really. Yes.
Okay, what's going to happen?
So, you may or may not be aware, but over the weeks, Josh has been writing all the material that goes into these videos, including the scripts and costumes and get-ups. And it seems that he's put many of the colour captains into some slightly awkward situations.
Oh, do you mean like this and like this and this and like this?
Those things. So what we thought as colour captains, Josh, is that it would be good to maybe spice this week up a little bit, with it being the last one of the term, and maybe change the announcements a little bit and give you a slightly different role in the announcements. And I'm sure, I mean, Josh hasn't seen this, but I'm sure you'll be happy to go with it, won't you, Josh?
Right, okay, I'm slightly nervous.
No, it's all good, it's
okay.
All good.
Okay.
It's definitely an improvement.
Okay, well, let's go to the announcements.
Welcome to the announcement section, which this morning is going to be a cracker. You'll see what I mean. Josh!
No, I don't
Josh.
Want... No, Dan, you can't make me. I don't want to...
Josh, come on. Nobody's going to be laughing at you.
I feel foolish.
Not foolish at all. You look great. Come on.
You sure?
Yeah, come on. It's going to be good to have you here.
I feel silly.
No, you don't look silly, Josh. You look good. Now, say the lines.
I don't want to say the lines.
You've got to say the lines. We had a deal. Come on.
Happy Easter to you all. We have some exciting announcements for you. Dan the Magnificent? Is that?
Perfect,
Dan
Josh.
The Magnificent. Do you want to tell us about the
more
first
meaning,
one?
More meaning. Dan the Magnificent. Anyway, let's tell you about them. Let's get on with it. So the first one is that next week, there will not be a video on this channel like there has been every week forever. Instead, we're going to be doing something a little bit different, which is an Easter Zoom. We're doing that with the whole church, so it's going to be a really brilliant thing to do. You need to sign up. The link will be in the bit below. That's at 10:15 next week, but the great thing is that the kids team are leading that, so it's going to be lots of fun. Make sure you sign up. Any thoughts on that, Josh?
It's going to be cracking. I've done this joke already. Excellent event.
Since when repeating jokes been a problem for you?
I carrot. Wait for it. Why are there so many Easter Bunny jokes?
It's
clearly
good.
Not.
It's good, Josh. It's very good. Right, okay. So that next week we've mentioned the Easter Zoom, but the week after we're going to have a break. Josh is tired. He needs to go and lie down. And the rest of us are going to sit at home and drink coffee for a week, but we're going to have a little bit of a breather before coming back to things.
And we're back on the 18th. And there's going to be a really exciting announcement video on that. So do make sure to check that one out. It doesn't even work.
Oh, it works very well, Josh. It works very, very well. Then other things to talk about. If that isn't enough already, we've got a trail at Rushcliffe Park, which is coming up, which again, the details will be below, and there'll be a sign up below. A bit like we did at Christmas, where there'll be kind of things to follow and find, and you never know, it could be a lot of fun. There might even be a...
Yeah, and if this video gets 100 likes, then I will go to that dressed as a chicken. No, I don't want to do that. No, Dan, I don't want to do that. No, I take that back.
No, he said it's on video. Would you say it, Josh? It's on video. So 100 likes, I mean, I think I could probably add about 25 of those. You're going to go dressed as a chicken. Rushcliffe Park is a public place, Josh.
Oh, dear.
That's good. So, even more reason for you to sign up for that. And again, don't forget to look below for the information.
Thank you for checking out the announcements. That's it. I'm done. I can't do this anymore.
I think that's the end of the announcements.
Okay, well, thank you, Dan, and the other colour captains. That was...
that was great.
Yeah, thank you for that. That was really exciting to be involved in. And
exciting. You just can't stop, can you?
And I'm glad that that's now on the internet. So, but I feel like you've got your revenge, which is probably fair. And
it's not about revenge, Josh. It's about equality.
Sorry, it's about including me in the
that's
city.
That's right. You've been
excellent. Well, just prepare for next term scripts to be even more silly. Great. Well, I think we should move on. We've got some stories we want to share.
We have, yes. So, as you know, for the past few weeks, we've been getting you to send us an email in stories of stuff that you've been doing around the theme of generosity. And it's been amazing, and we've heard some great stories. So I'll give you an example, if that's okay.
Absolutely.
So Lara has been incredibly generous, and she bought, with her own pocket money, jelly beans and biscuits, not one nor the other, both, to give to the bin men and the postman. Yeah, that's just amazing. Well done, Lara.
That's great. And we heard from Luke and Isla, who have been doing something similar. They've been buying chocolates for the key workers that Trent have been supporting. So amazing work from you guys as well. And we also got another email in. This one didn't have a name.
Yeah, someone who wants to stay anonymous.
Someone who wants to stay anonymous. It could be the Challenge Master. Probably not. Probably not. But they have been using, again, their own pocket money to buy chickens.
Yes.
For people living in Uganda, and they can lay eggs. And
that's amazing.
It's an amazing thing to do. So if that is you, well done. Great work. We have your email, so we'll send you a t-shirt anyway.
And that, just to prove the theme of generosity, that's because, you know, we're going to give some stuff away.
Yeah. Where's it gone, Dan?
It's gone down here. It's going to be
there it is.
Here we go. Completely natural and professional. Here we are. So, the t-shirts are on their way to say thank you for being generous and well done. And you can have a Trent Kids t-shirt that looks very much like this.
Yeah. Amazing.
It's amazing.
Yeah, and you know, we can't give away t-shirts forever.
No.
But we do want to keep hearing your stories of generosity even after Easter. So anything that goes on after Easter.
Yeah, or any exciting things that are going on in your life that would be great for us to share. We'd love to hear from you. The email address, as always.
That wasn't another pun, was it? The exciting?
No. Same pun.
Okay, great. Anyway, I think it's time to move on now, and it's time to go into time of worship, a time where we show and tell God how amazing he is to us. And this week we're going to do that through dance. So we're going to go to the dance team who are going to lead us in worship.
Alive.
Let's just pray. Father, we are so grateful that we get to celebrate and worship with you, that we can thank you for Easter and for the happy day that it is and for everything that you do for us and did for us on the cross. Mm. Let's do a big amen. You ready?
Yeah, definitely.
Amen!
Oh, that's a good one. Amazing. Well, as we said earlier, today is the last video in this Deep Roots series that we've been doing all the way since January.
Yeah.
It's been a long time, and over that time we've covered a lot of stuff, haven't we? But the question is, how carefully were you paying attention? And there's only one way to find out, with a quiz we like to call
The Isolation Game.
Hello, hello, hello. I'm your host, Ash Wednesday, and welcome back to The Isolation Game, the show where we pit your observational skills against each other. I'm sure you know the deal by now, but for players new to the game, I will ask you a question based on the videos from this term and give you two possible answers. Your job is to work out which of those answers is correct. If you think it's A, I want you to jump up and down like you've got ants in your pants. And if you think it's B, I want you to freeze like you've been trapped in ice. So A, jump up and down, and B, freeze. Anyway, enough talking. Let's get into the questions. Okay, question number one. In week two, Josh and Anna talked about the Holy Spirit and the difference the Holy Spirit makes to us. But what did Josh say that the Holy Spirit was like? Was it A, the Holy Spirit is like a candle in the wind? Or was it B, the Holy Spirit is like the batteries in a torch? Was it A, a candle in the wind? Or B, the batteries in a torch? Have a think, have a think. If you think it's A, I want you to jump up and down like you've got ants in your pants. And if you think it's B, you should be there frozen. What was it? What was it? That's enough time. It was, of course, B. The Holy Spirit is like the batteries in a torch. So well done if you got that right. You're a winner. Okay, question number two. In week three, Andy and Rachel played a game of Draw Your Sword, where they competed to find Bible verses the fastest. But what was the problem with Rachel's Bible? Was it A, it was big, heavy, and written in old-fashioned languages? Or was it B, somebody had eaten some of the pages? So was it A, it was big and heavy and written in old-fashioned language? Or was it B, someone had eaten some of the pages? Have a think, have a think. Okay, okay, what is it? That's enough time. It was, of course, A. It was big, heavy, and written in old-fashioned language. So well done if you got that one right. You also are a winner. Okay, moving on. Question number three. In week four, we caught up with the Challenge Master, who was in a rowing boat. But why was he in a rowing boat? Was it A, he was rowing to Australia to get a sample of koala bear bad breath to put into the Gunge? Could be. Or was it B, he was attempting to break the world record for the longest time spent in a boat? Both good options. Which one was it? Was it A, he was rowing to Australia to collect a sample of koala bear bad breath to put into the Gunge? Or was it B, he was attempting to break the world record for the longest time spent in a boat? That is a mouthful. Oh, but which one was it? You guys all know at home. It was, of course, drumroll, it was A, he was rowing to Australia to get a sample of koala bad breath for the Gunge. So well done if you're jumping up and down. Okay, question numero four. In week five, Chris dropped by to help us understand how we can hear from God better. During this interview, he brought an unexpected thing in to show Josh to teach us how God can sometimes get our attention with strange things. But what was the unexpected thing that he brought in? Was it A, a parrot? Or was it B, a tiny little piano? Was it A, a parrot? Or B, a tiny little piano? One more time. Was it A, a parrot? Or B, a tiny little piano? Okay, have a think. Have a think. What was it? Search your memories. It's in there. What did he bring? It was unexpected, but what was it? Okay, stop, stop, stop. Stop thinking, stop thinking, stop thinking. It was, of course, A, it was a parrot. So well done if you got that one right. Okay, question number 5, not many left now. In week 7, we talked about worship. I wonder whether you remember that. During that session, Dan met someone very surprising in a Lidl car park. But who was it? Who did Dan meet in a Lidl car park? Was it A, Batman? Or was it B, the Queen? Was it A, Batman? Or was it B, the Queen? So either you're jumping up and down or you're frozen. Which one was it? Which one was it? It was, of course, B. He met the Queen in the car park. So well done if you're frozen. You're a winner. Okay, question number 6. Last week, if you can remember back that far, last week, Luke and Rachel helped us celebrate our 1-year anniversary of Trent Kids Online. During that video, Luke mentioned how many videos Trent Kids have made this year, but what was that number? Was it A, 143 videos? Or was it B, 176 videos? Was it A, 143 videos? Or B, 176? This is a tricky one. This is a tricky one. Oh, how many have you watched? Oh, add those together and take away the remainder and... Oh, I've lost count. It was, of course, drumroll, B, 176. So well done if you're frozen. And the final question now. Question number 7. All to play for now. On week 6, Trent Kids legend Josh stopped by to encourage us all to do something. But what was that? Was it A, he encouraged us to exercise more? Or was it B, he encouraged us to find opportunities to be generous? Was it A, he encouraged us to exercise more? Or B, he encouraged us to find opportunities to be generous? What was it? Oh, have a think. I remember the interview, but what did he say? Okay, stop. Come on, stop. Stop. Thank you. Oh, don't listen. Okay, the correct answer was B. He encouraged us to find opportunities to be generous. So well done if you're frozen. Okay, well, that's the end of the quiz. It's out of 7 this time. So tot up your score. What did you get? What did you get? Might need you use your fingers and your toes to count it all up. Okay. Hopefully you got your number by now. I want you to give me a cheer if you got, let's say, 4 or more. Ooh, okay. Quite a few of you. Very smart cookies. Okay, what about 5 or more? Oh, hello. Okay. But surely none of you got 7 out of 7. Oh, wow. You are some smart cookies. But you know what? You're all winners to me. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you next time on...
The Isolation Game.
Amazing. So, there we go. I hope you did better than me. I only got 3. Now, over the last 10 weeks, we've looked at a bunch of things that we can do regularly that will help us to be more like Jesus. Some of those things might have been completely new to you. Maybe you'd never heard of fasting or Sabbath before. But I'm sure that lots of them were reminders of things that we knew already.
But as we've said a number of times, the point of looking at these practices is not so that we can know lots. It's not so that you can impress your friends with how much you might know about generosity or the Bible or worship. But it's so that you guys can actually learn to do them. We believe that if you guys watching start putting into practice some of the things that we've looked at this term, then you will see your life and your relationship with God grow in amazing ways.
Way back in January, Josh and Anna used the picture of a seed. They said that if you give a seed water, sunlight, and good soil, then that seed will grow to become a beautiful plant. In the same way, if we fill our lives with all the things we've talked about this term, we'll find that we also grow. If we ask to be regularly filled with the Holy Spirit, if we read our Bibles often, if we spend time talking and listening with God each week, if we practice generosity wherever we see need, if we worship regularly, if we take time to Sabbath each week, if we're thankful daily, and if we get into the habit of fasting, then before long, we'll notice that we are different. We'll notice that we are thinking and acting more and more like Jesus, and we'll find that our relationship with our Father God is getting stronger and stronger each day.
So, as we come to the end of our Deep Roots series, the question we're left with is, do we want that? Do we want to keep growing closer to God? Because God's not going to force us to do anything that we don't want to do. But if we do want to grow in our relationship with God, if we do want to grow to be the kind of world-changing followers of Jesus that we read about in the Bible, then it's so, so important that we learn to make these 9 things a part of our regular lives. So for the last time this term, let's remind ourselves of what those are.
We should regularly ask God to fill us with His Holy Spirit, because it's His Spirit that gives us the power to be more like Jesus and to make the world look more like heaven.
We should spend time getting to know our Bibles better, because it's through them that we learn what God is like and how He wants us to live. We can do that through reading, listening, watching, or even playing with apps.
We should also talk with God regularly. We can talk with Him about anything that's on our hearts, and He promises that He will hear us and that He cares.
And we should also listen to God. God wants to speak with us, and we should get into the habit of making space to hear what He might want to say to us.
We should also practice being generous. We should use the gifts and the blessings that God has given to us to love and to serve others.
We should also regularly worship. We should take the time to show and tell God how amazing we think He really is. We can do that with our words, our songs, our dance, our skills, and even the way that we live our lives.
We should learn to Sabbath. We should take a day off each week where we don't work and where we learn to enjoy God and all that He's given to us.
We should also remember to be thankful and regularly thank God for all the good things that we have.
And finally, we should learn to fast. We should learn to give up some of the good things in our lives for short periods so that we can better focus our hearts on God. Now, doing these things isn't always easy. We hope that over the course of this term, we've given you loads of fun ideas of how to get started with these and to make them more interesting. But the truth is that there will probably be lots of days where we just can't be bothered about reading our Bibles or worshiping or fasting. And in many ways, that's okay. Don't think you failed if you go a week without praying. But what we want to say to you is that the more you practice doing these things, the easier they become, and the more they'll start to feel like things that you look forward to doing.
So don't give up when it feels hard. Ask your grown-ups for help. Rewatch the videos from this term if you want reminders, but also remember to ask God. God wants to help us as we look to grow. And remember, we don't all need to be experts in all of these things by the end of the year. We have our entire lives to work on these. So just try them out and keep trying them out and keep trying them out some more. And as you do, I am convinced that you will see more of God working in your lives, and others will see more of God working in you.
Great stuff. So I think it'd be great just to kind of finish off the morning with a bit of prayer.
Yeah.
And as we've just said, you know, the things we've talked about this whole term are not necessarily going to come easily the first time. We have to practice them.
Yeah.
This is the kind of thing where we have to give it a go. It doesn't matter if we fail a bit. But what really helps us with this is when we get God involved and when we invite the Holy Spirit to fill us again and to give us the power and the energy to do it. So I think that's where we should go. We started the term out with it. Let's end the term in the same way.
Yeah.
Let's invite the Holy Spirit and ask Him to fill us again to help us to do all this stuff. So let's do that. You can sit, you can stand, you can kneel, you can put your hands out. It's entirely up to you, but do just concentrate and let's ask God and the Holy Spirit to fill us. Yes, Lord. Yes, we welcome You. Holy Spirit, we welcome You. Wherever we are, in our homes, in this studio, all around the city, all around the country, maybe even all around the world, You are with us. Holy Spirit, would You fill us again?
And God, we just ask for Your help as we try and do these things, as we try and make these things a part of our lives, would you help us? We pray against discouragement when, you know, we might not get it right. We pray that you would be with us, that you'd help us just get back on and try it again, Lord. And we pray that as we do these things, that we would just grow closer to you, that we would hear you speak to us more. We would feel you guiding us more. And Lord, we just want to become the kind of people that you made us to be. We want to love you. We want to serve you. And I just pray that you would just take us on that journey. We just thank you for these wonderful gifts that you give us to get closer to you. And would you just help us to put them into practice, Jesus? In Jesus' name. Should we finish with one big
amen? One
big,
yep.
Amen!
Brilliant. Oh,
so good.
Wow.
Amazing. Well, that's us done, isn't it?
It is. That is. That's the end of the series. And don't forget, you can go back and watch them at any time. They'll stay up on the internet.
Yep, they'll be there. So you can go back and rewatch it. And just a reminder from what we said earlier, next week, there isn't going to be a video, but we are going to gather together for a big Zoom. We'd love to see you as part of that. Then the week after, we're taking a bit of a break, so there'll be something slightly different up on the channel. But we'll be back the week after with some really exciting announcements.
Yeah.
So we want to see you there, or we'll see you at this the Easter Trail resource thing. So, yeah.
That's great. Well, I think we're done, aren't we?
We're pretty much done. I think we've done everything.
I can't think of anything else that needs to happen.
It's been a wonderful series.
What a wonderful series.
What a wonderful time. So that's us done. Just to say we missed you.
Yeah.
We're praying for you and we'll see you after Easter.
Yeah. See you. Bye.
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 Oh, we got you. You thought we were going to finish, but of course, no.
No.
We can't finish without concluding.
No.
The Gunge in this term.
Yeah, there is a big cliffhanger being left there, and obviously we need to know that you're going to get Gunged.
Or you.
Not me, not me.
So without further ado, for the last time this term, let's go play the...
So, welcome to the final Colour Captain Challenge of the term.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's all to play for. It's, I think, both Josh and myself are...
It's crunch time, isn't it?
...holding up the rest of the colour captains on 2 points.
Well, let's just see the scoreboard.
Yeah.
As we can see, Rachel's at the top, mostly irrelevant.
Yeah.
But then if we scroll down...
This is where it's all happening today. 2 points, Josh.
Yeah. I mean, it is a little bit unjust. I will get my excuses in advance.
Yeah, and I certainly shouldn't be down there.
But I don't think... We're just going to have to deal with it, aren't we?
We are, yes. And that means it's all to play for today, of course. So.
Yeah, one of us is going to get Gunged. And talking of Gunged, obviously last week we saw the Challenge Master finish off making the Gunged from his disgusting ingredients all around the world. It's unpleasant. He left it a week just stewing, and then he couriered it overnight. It arrived this morning.
Mm.
And
what's interesting, Josh, is after a week of stewing, it seems to have dissolved all the ingredients into one humming...
Yeah.
Slimy, grim mess, except for your Yorkshire puddings, which have withstood that.
Yeah, my Yorkshire puddings. They're just, it's a robust recipe, that's all I'll say.
It certainly is.
Not good for the stomach, but yeah, it smells awful. I mean, there's no two ways about it. It's horrible, it's thick, it's unpleasant.
Mm.
It's both slimy and cold and warm at the same time.
I'm not sure the microphones will pick it up, but it's actually emitting a low hum all the time.
It's unpleasant.
Deeply.
So neither of us want to get Gunged, if we're honest, but the reality is one of us are.
That's right. So I think we should, without further ado, move on to the actual event itself. So we need to speak to the man. Challenge Master, are you there?
Greetings, Colour Captains. I am the Challenge Master and welcome to the finale of a glorious term of challenges. How are you both feeling?
I mean, not great if I'm honest, Challenge Master. I mean, the prospect of two Gungeons in a row is not a particularly exciting prospect for me.
No, actually, I'm feeling kind of quietly confident, to be honest.
Are you?
Yeah, I am. Partly because I'm up against you. And secondly, because I've been checking out the emails from the kids and quite a lot of them seem to have figured out who you are, Challenge Master. And they seem quite keen that Josh gets Gunged, which of course is good news for me.
Oh dear.
Of course the kids have worked it out. They're such a clever bunch. So who do they think I am?
Well, Challenge Master, the kids have been using technology, they have been using deduction, some of them have been spying, and they have come to a very clear conclusion. So are you ready? Drum roll, please. The kids have almost unanimously come to the conclusion that you are none other than our very own James Pitcher! Yes!
Is this?
I'm afraid that that's incorrect.
What? What? You cannot be serious. That, like, the kids have completely come to that conclusion. And what?
I know. I've dodged a bullet there, because I was starting to think it was James as well, but I dodged a bullet there.
How is it not James?
So there's only one thing left for us to do then, Dan. We've exhausted all avenues. We are just going to have to play off against each other for this final challenge to decide who is going to get gunged. So how are you feeling now?
Now I'm beginning to feel a little bit nervous.
Yeah.
I thought I was completely clear of this.
So, Challenge Master, what's the challenge today?
Well, with Easter just around the corner, I've decided to make today's challenge a special Easter one. As we all know, one of our favourite bits of Easter each year is the eggs.
Oh, yes, I love a good chocolate egg.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, if you look in front of you, you will see I have provided you with a set of 12 eggs.
Right, okay. Well, this can only go well.
9 of these eggs are hard-boiled, but 3 of them remain raw. Your challenge is to, one at a time, take an egg from the box and break it on your head. If it is hard-boiled, then you're safe. But if it is raw, then you might get rather messy. The first colour captain to break 2 raw eggs over their head will lose. And unfortunately, that also means Gunge. Do you understand?
Yeah?
Well, for the last time this term, good luck!
Okay, great. So we've got our final colour captain challenge.
We have.
In normal Challenge Master style, he's gone a little bit Eastery, a little bit themey, but kind of missed the mark on it a little bit. So we've got 12 eggs here.
Mm-hmm.
9 of them are hard boiled, which mm-hmm. means when we splat them on our heads,
yes,
hopefully,
yeah,
we don't get covered in egg.
Yeah,
okay. Shell might go everywhere, but we hopefully yeah. will stay all right. But okay. 3 of them
mm-hmm.
are raw.
Raw.
Which means when we smack them on our head, we are going to get covered.
It's very good for your hair, Josh.
In egg. Oh, that's good for me. Less good for you.
It's like looking at 12 mirrors for me.
Yep, brilliant. Okay. So it's the first one to break 2 raw eggs on their head.
Yeah, okay. Well, best of 3, yeah. Okay, best so first 2, bad.
So if you break raws, one, it's not the end of the
I'm
world.
I'm with you.
If you break the second one,
that's when
you lose.
Okay, all right.
Okay, are you okay? How are you feeling?
I'm feeling reasonably confident.
I've genuinely got butterflies.
Okay.
Like, I generally am a little bit nervous about this.
Okay, who's going first?
Well, I think you've done less challenges this series, so I think it's only fair that you go first.
Okay.
So,
can I touch them? Can I feel them?
You can.
As soon as you touch it,
you've got to take it. Just, you know. So, we need lots of support from you at home. And let's just do it.
Let's go
straight away. You pick first.
Okay. So for me, okay, let's go with... I'm going to go with one near you. I'm going to the away territory. I'll go with this one here.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Oh, yes. Hard boiled.
Did that hurt?
No, it's okay.
Okay. Well, you took one closest to me, so I'm going to take one closer to you.
I've got a feeling. It's going to be messy.
I don't know. It feels firm. So
okay.
Let's just do it. Just get it over and done with. 3, 2, 1.
Oh, no. Oh, Josh.
I mean, my hair softened it, but that was hard boiled.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Right, okay.
So 10 left. Still 3 raw eggs out there. Which is it going to be?
Ah, oh, crumbs. This is tricky. I'm going to go with this one here.
Okay. How does it feel?
Smells eggy.
Okay.
Here we go. Ready?
Ready.
3, 2, 1. Oh! No!
Oh, that is raw.
Oh, that is definitely Raw. Oh, that's actually
okay.
In my socks. How did I get that in my socks? That is in my socks.
Right, okay. So...
It's going on.
Right, that's one down.
Oh, great.
Okay, so I've got the lead at the moment. I just need to keep it.
Mm-hmm.
I am going to
pick... I can choose for you.
No, I'm going to pick this one, I reckon. I've got a good feeling. Right, ready?
No.
Countdown at home. 3, 2, 1.
Yeah! Oh, that's one all. That's one all, Josh. That's one all. There's only one more left.
Right, okay, that was Raw.
That's a good look.
Right, okay. So, there's okay. How many left? How many left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 left.
Okay.
Only one Raw egg left, but okay. Whoever pulls the next one is out.
Okay. I'm going to go with... No, I'm not. Yes, I am going with this one.
Okay.
I'm going with this one. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Oh!
Ow! That's definitely hard boiled.
Yeah, they are quite hard.
Ow.
So, okay, I'm just gonna feel it out. Just gonna take this one and just go. Oh, that broke a lot, but no, hard boiled. It's difficult to tell now that my entire head is covered in egg.
Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna go your end again.
Okay.
Okay. No pressure. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Ah! I need to hit it on a different part of my head. You get sore.
My hands are so sticky.
I've got egg on my.
Okay,
eye.
So we have got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 eggs left.
Five left.
So we've done 7. There's one in five. I'm going to take the one closest to me.
Okay. This is the one. This is the one.
Ready?
Yeah.
I don't want to get gunged. Oh!
Gosh.
Okay. Right, four one left. Four. One in four chance.
Okay, I'm gonna go in the middle. I'm gonna go one of these middle ones here. I'm gonna go with this one. Am I going to go with this one? I do not. It's not the egg I'm bothered about, it's the gunging, okay? Let's be clear. I'm gonna go with this one. 3, 2, 1, go! Yes! And no, ow! Ow!
Okay.
3, 1 in 3.
Oh no, 1 in 3!
Come on, Josh, come on, you wanna get it?
Okay.
You gotta get it. Gotta
okay,
get it.
I'm just gonna feel it out. Feel it out.
Oh, come on.
1 in 3. The next person who breaks an egg over the head is getting gunged.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to take the one closest to you.
Okay, I can't tell the relief when it's not my turn. It's amazing.
Oh, no, this feels...
It feels like an egg.
It feels...
Come on. It's got to be raw. Three.
Okay, 3, 2. 2, 1.
God. Yes! 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 Oh, yes, Josh. Oh, look at that.
Oh my goodness, so I've broken two eggs
on
my
head,
which means I lose the challenge, but does that mean I'm getting gunged?
I'm afraid it does, Josh. And to think I had such high hopes for you this term.
But wait, if I can guess your secret identity right, then I can avoid getting gunged, and the next person at the bottom of the leader table will get gunged, which I think would be you, Dan, right?
Well, I guess so, but that's never going to...
Challenge Master, are you John Wright?
I'm sorry? What did you say?
You know, John Wright, the guy who, leads the church with his wife, Debbie? Is that who you are, Challenge Master?
There is no way it's John Wright. He has not got time to do all this.
Turn the machine off.
Well, congratulations, Josh. You have correctly guessed my secret identity.
No!
Yes!
No
yes!
way! No way!
Yes!
No way!
Yes!
No way, Josh!
Yes!
No, no!
Yes!
No way did you just guess that! No way did you just guess
yes,
that!
Yes, I did! What are you suggesting, Dan? That I managed to convince John Wright, who leads this church and the vineyard movement in UK and Ireland, I'm actually convinced that John Wright to come in especially, film on our green screen, pretending to be the Challenge Master as a one-off just so that I could avoid getting gunched. Is that really what you're suggesting?
I mean, I guess it sounds a little bit far-fetched.
Exactly.
So what's this mean? What happens now?
Well, Dan, I'm afraid it's you who now finishes at the bottom of the table. Which means, unfortunately, it is you who will now experience a glorious and disgusting gunging. Are you ready? Good luck!
Okay, so here we are at the Gunge. I've narrowly avoided it, but Dan, you're gonna get gunged. How are you feeling?
Yeah.
Not so great. It's all right, I've checked, it's nice and warm. It's a bit smelly though. So, let's have a big countdown from home as loud as we possibly can. Dan, you ready?
No.
Okay, he says he absolutely is. Let's go. 5, 4,
no.
3, 2, 1, let's go! Okay, how are we feeling, Dan?
Well, the fact I looked at my mouth open as the second bucket came in was a mistake.
It may have gone some of it in Dan's mouth. We'll check with the Challenge Master whether it's lethal, but I don't think it is. Dan, thank you so much. Let's give him a round of applause. What a trooper. But that's the end of the Colour Captain Challenge for this term. Unlucky, Dan, but we'll see who's going to get gunged next term. Thank you so much for joining us. This term and this morning, we hope it's been really good fun for you. Just a reminder about the Easter Zoom next week. We'd love to see you then. But otherwise, we'll see you after Easter. Should we wave goodbye, Dan? We'll see you after Easter. Bye.
Greetings, Colour Captains. I am the Challenge Master. Sorry I'm late. Believe it or not, someone locked me in my secret lab. I can't imagine why anybody would do such a thing. But never fear, I'm here now to preside over this week's glorious Gunge. What? You've already done it? You did it without me? But I was there. Josh correctly guessed my identity, but who did he say I am? John Wright. But that is incorrect. I am, in fact, as so many of you cleverly guessed,
James Pitcher, the Colour Captain. It's me. Well done for so many of you correctly guessing that I was the Challenge Master. But why would Josh get John Wright, leader of Trent Vineyard and the National Vineyard Movement, to stand in as Challenge Master on Gunging Week? Unless... the cheat!